Hello and welcome to 5 Minute Math. Today we are looking at the sixth grade concept of ratios and percents, specifically how we can represent them in multiple ways, and we'll do it in 5 minutes or less. So we have a basic fraction here represented with this rectangle, and we're looking first off for the ratio of the red cells to the total number of cells. So that seems like it'd be pretty simple, so we'll put our ratio over here. And we're going to count our red cells. And so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cells. And then a total number of cells. Well, that's going to be 16. So our ratio would be 6 to 16. But how can we make that look like a fraction? Well, one way to think of a ratio and fraction, how they're related, is that they operate very similarly. And most of the time, you can just take your ratio and you can move it 90 degrees to the right. You can just kind of rotate it clockwise 90 degrees, and so your left term becomes your numerator and your right term becomes your denominator. So you see how we move these here. So 6/16 is how we can look at that, and since it is a fraction, we'll go ahead and see if we can reduce it. We can reduce both top and bottom if we divide by 2/2. So a better fraction would be 3/8. So 6/16, 3/8. Now, how could we do that as a decimal? Well, if we're converting fractions to decimal, one of the simplest things to do, unless you have a denominator that's easily changed into 10, 100, or 1,000, is to simply divide up. And when I say divide up, that means you're going to take your denominator, in this case your 8, we'll use our simplified version, we're going to divide it up into the numerator, in this case 3. And so we should know that 8 does not go into 3, but that's where we put our decimal here, and we extend our problem. So 8 goes into 30. Well, 8 goes into 30, not quite 4 times, we're going to make it 3 times. So that's 24, and we just keep adding zeros since they're after the decimal, and that's going to be fine. So 8 goes into 60, and that's going to be 7 times, not quite 8 times. That's 56, and you see we're running out of room down here at the bottom, but 8 goes into 40, that's going to be 5 times, and that's going to be even. So 3/8, 0.375, or 375 thousandths, and once you have the decimal, changing it to a percent is fairly simple, because you take your decimal, in this case we have 375 thousandths, and you simply move the decimal twice to the right. So in this case, we have 37.5%. So this particular figure here can be represented as a ratio of 6 to 16, as a fraction of 3/8, as a decimal of 0.375, and as a percent of 37.5%. They all represent this particular figure. Now it's time for you to try. Take a moment, pause the video, and see if you can figure out the ratio, the fraction, the decimal, and percent of the red slices to the total number of slices. When you have your answer, unpause the video and check your work. Figuring out the ratio is pretty easy. You got 7 red to a total of 12. So that's going to be 7/12 as your fraction. Remember, our decimal, we're going to divide up. We're going to take our denominator, 12, and divide it into 7. It goes 0 times. Let's add a decimal 0, and we can continue our long division this way, and so that's going to give us a remainder of 10. Add another 0 here, so times 12 going to 100. That's going to get us pretty close with an 8. That's 96. That's a remainder of 4. And so 12 goes into, let's see, 4 3 times. But what we should notice here is we had a remainder of 4. We divided that into 43 times, and we have a remainder of 4 again. And so what's going to end up happening is this is an irrational number. 12 goes into 40, it's going to go in 3 times, and we're going to follow the cycle again and again and again. It never ends. And so we're going to call this 0.58. Then we're going to put a little bar over the 3, because the 3 is going to repeat forever. And then your decimal changes to a percent by moving it over twice, once, twice, and so it's going to be 58.3 repeating percent, or you might like it to be 58 1/3%.